The Markle debacle forced Meghan to cut off contact with her family altogether, but it seems Her Majesty is less than impressed with the drama. While it was the year Harry and Meghan tied the knot, there's no doubt the royal couple will be glad to see the back of 2018. The Duchess of Sussex has been repeatedly embarrassed by her family, most notably her father, who continues to give interview after interview to the press. And apparently, the Queen is unimpressed with the handling of the delicate situation. Thomas Markle Sr. has spoken out at length after he was forced to pull out of the royal wedding in May. The drama forced Meghan to cut off contact with her family altogether, but it seems Her Majesty is less than impressed with the drama. Vanity Fair quoted a source as saying, she, the Queen, was very concerned that it, the Markle situation, was spiraling out of control, which it was. Buckingham Palace wanted to be able to do something and be proactive and make the situation go away. It was a direction from the Queen, so her courtiers were under strict instructions to sort it out. But Kensington Palace was not singing from the same hymn sheet, and that was because the message was coming from Meghan. She didn't want to engage and thought that she could handle it on her own. It comes as the Queen plans to use her Christmas Day broadcast to emphasize that the message of goodwill to all is needed as much now as ever. With the country and Parliament deeply divided over Brexit, and military conflicts raging in parts of the world, her words will resonate with many. There are also rumors of a falling out between the Duchesses, Meghan and sister-in-law Kate, who are two of the royals due to be spending Christmas Day with the Queen at Sandringham. In her broadcast, the monarch will talk about her Christian faith and highlight much-loved words in the Bible about understanding and harmony. The Queen, 92, will say, "I believe the message of peace on earth and goodwill to all is never out of date. It can be heeded by everyone, it's needed as much as ever. Even with the most deeply held differences, treating the other person with respect and as a fellow human being is always a good first step towards greater understanding." The Queen is publicly neutral on politics and does not express her views on issues. But some commentators may interpret her words as a veiled reference to the toxic mood in relation to Brexit. The address, written by the Queen, reflects on current events. Highlights of 2018 include England reaching the Football World Cup semi-finals, and the weddings of Prince Harry and Meghan, and Princess Eugenie and Jack Brooksbank. The Queen, who has reigned since 1952, will also say, "Through the many changes I have seen over the years, faith, family and friendship have been not only a constant for me but a source of personal comfort." She has 8 grandchildren and 7 great-grandchildren, with another on the way because Harry and Meghan are expecting their first child in the spring. The speech was recorded on December 12 in the White Drawing Room at Buckingham Palace. During the message, produced this year by Sky News, the monarch wears an Angela Kelly ivory silk cocktail dress and the gold scarab brooch that the Duke of Edinburgh gave her in 1966. She is sitting at a desk with a photo from 1949 of herself with Prince Philip and Prince Charles when he was a baby. The Queen arrived at the Sandringham Estate in Norfolk on Thursday for her festive break. Well-wishers greeted her in the rain yesterday as she attended church nearby.